Right, I made a darkness stone. It's a piece of calcite crystal. I used a permanent marker, and I'm holding it against the monitor, and the monitor is polarized. It's actually polarized at 45 degrees, so that if you hold it monitor sideways or upright, you can still see it with sunglasses on. If not, it will appear black if you have polarized sunglasses. So as I turn it, the dot gets lighter and darker. Now you'll be holding it up at the sky looking like this, and when the dots are equally light or equally dark, then you know that the top edge is facing the sun. I'll tell you in a minute which way to look. So you get it equally, then you know how it's polarized. You'll see that it's 45 on the monitor. The sun is different, and you're looking at a piece of paper. Just ignore the dots for a second. You'll see that it double refracts, and as you turn it, the horizontal line will become single bar, and the vertical line will become double. Now as you turn it, the horizontal line becomes double, and eventually the vertical single. Now what you do is, if you hold the stone like I got it right now to where, what you'll see in a second, to where both horizontal and vertical lines are equally double, then the flat upper end of the stone will point towards the sun. So it's horizontal, but look at where the arrow is pointing, exactly vertical, or at 90 degrees from the top edge of the stone will be towards the sun. Also, if you notice, I pick up the crystal and turn it, the dots are the same. It's one dot that looks double, and it won't change in shade. That's because I'm not looking at any polarized light. So when you look up at the sun, you'll definitely get a difference. You'll be able to see the light. So when the dots equal light and dark, then you know you're looking at the sun. Now in heavy cloud cover, it's difficult to extinguish. You'll get what will look like two dots equally shaded, and as you move it, one will become slightly less dark than the other. If you got a bit of blue above you, even if you're surrounded by trees and forest, you will still be able to see, and with a bit of blue above you, the dot will be very clearly visible either one side or the other. And just get it the right shade, and then you'll know where the sun is. So I encourage people to try this out. It's a lot of fun, and where I live, there's fog all the time, and or cloud cover, or I'm in heavy forest. I live in the far north, so it really helps me to find the sun, especially since compasses don't work well in certain areas where I live. Get a lot of interference, and in the tree cover so far up north, GPS doesn't seem to work very well either. So you know, although you might not use this very often, it is definitely a fun thing to do, and it'll tell you where the sun is. So I encourage you to try it out. I'm going to leave links to where you can get these stones, and it's fun to play with. If you hold it upwards, you could put a dot in it, an arrow, a line. It doesn't really matter what you use. You just have to pay attention to that the refraction. Also, I've seen documentaries that do really strange things that don't seem to make sense and haven't worked for me, and they don't seem to have worked for other people too. So I hope this helps you finding the sunlight. Let me know if you have any questions.